So, good morning everyone. Today we will start with frequency sampling method. It is also regarded as Fourier transform method for the FIR filter designing. Say for example, you are given with an question, design a low pass filter with the following specification. The cutoff frequency is 500 Hz, sampling frequency is 2000 Hz. And order of the filter n it is equal to 10. Okay, so first we have to do the normalization of the frequency and find out in radians what should be the frequency. So omega c it is equal to fc by 2 pi fc by fs, which gives us pi by 2. Okay, so from here we will then determine the transfer function. What is the transfer function? HK, where K stands for the frequency component. So HK equals to 1 in the region of 0 to pi by 2 modulus of omega. Okay, and 0 in the other frequency components. Okay, so from here we will draw the frequency response of the filter. So if you see, this is the frequency in the response we have plot. However, over here we have taken 0 to 2 pi. Okay, now it is having a value of 1. The filter, it is having an amplitude response of 1 till pi by 2, which is the omega c. And then from 3 pi by 2, it should have, which is basically 2 pi minus pi by 2. Okay? Why? Because we are having a bandwidth of 0 to pi by 2. That means we are having a bandwidth of pi by 2 from DC to pi by 2. Right? Now, when we are taking 0 to 2 pi, 2 pi corresponds to 0. So in our previous cases we have seen, if you take this Z transform and if you place a pole over here, if it is having an effect of up to frequency omega c, then in the negative half also will be having the effect of the pole till minus of omega c, right? So by that logic, we come to this point where we have omega c dash, which is at 2 pi minus pi by 2, which comes out to be 3 pi by 2. Okay, so over here we are having this one, right? Now, if you see, I have just broken down into the decimal points 1.57, then pi comes out to be 3.14. And 3 pi by 2, it is 2.471, and 2 pi, it is 6.28. Okay, now we have to sample this frequency domain component. Okay, that's why we call it frequency sampling method. Okay, frequency sampling method. Okay, so what should be the delta frequency at which we will be sampling? The delta frequency would be 2 pi by n minus 1. 2 pi by n minus 1 Okay, so n minus 1, n we have seen 10, so it comes out to be 11. And at what point we will be sampling? So that will be given by K of delta. Okay, and the points will be given by 2 K pi by n plus 1. Okay, so 2 K pi n plus 1. Now, what is the range of this K? The range of this K would be again 0 to 10. Okay, 0 to 10. So that will give us 11 number of points. Okay, so if you see, So when I have varied k from 0 to 10, correspondingly I get some delta k values, k delta values. So for 0 it is 0, for 1 it is 0.57, for 2 it is 1.14, for 3 it is 1.71, for 4 it is 2.28, for 5 it is 2.86, for 6 it is 3.43, for 7 it is 4. So basically the 4 comes by approximating 3.998. okay, then for the k value of 8 we get 4.57, for 9 we get 5.14, and for 10 we get 5.71. I have again calculated this for k equals to 11, which gives us 6.28, which is again the 2 pi. So this has been calculated just for checking purpose. It has nothing to do with the numerical, okay? Because 2 pi and 0, if you look into this Z transform, the 2 pi and 0, they form the same point, okay? So you do not need the values, k delta values, where k is equal to 11. Okay, now once you have calculated this, you have to look into this k delta values and compare it with the frequency response, where we have discussed about the sampling of the frequency response. In this case, if you see, we are having omega c, which is having a value of pi by 2. So pi by 2 means 1.57, right? 1.57. Now if you look into this k by k delta values after k equals to 2, where we have got k delta value of 1.14, when we went for k equals to 3, we have got k delta value of 1.71, right? Now if we compare this omega c value, it lies somewhere in between 2 and 3, but we are having discrete values, so we cannot go beyond this 1.57. so what is the minimum value over here? I can go up to 0, 1, 2. So we have to take this values, okay? Similarly, if you look into the higher frequency components, we have 3 pi by 2, and 3 pi by 2 is given by 4.71. So if you see, after k equals to 8, where it is, we are having 4.57, it is lower than 4.71, so we will not consider that. So how many points we will be having in the higher frequency domain? We will be having the values where k equals to 9 and 10. Okay, so in this way we need to find out the limits of the k values, where the k value will exist. Okay, where the k value will exist. Just a minute. Now from here, what we get? We get the values of H3, H4, H5, H6, H7 and H8, they are having a values of 0. So in this region, pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, we are having the amplitude values of 0. So we directly put the value of 0. Okay, now we have determined at what positions we will be having what values. Now previously we have seen that we have considered this continuous spectrum. So h cap k, which is basically the sampled system or the sample points, how we will be getting that? We will be getting in this fashion: h cap 0, it is 1, h cap 1, it will be given by e to the power minus j omega alpha k. Okay, so what is alpha? Alpha is l minus 1 by 2, which is equal to 5, and the k value. So for h1 the k value is 1, so we have e to the power minus j 2 pi by 11 multiplied by 1, okay, multiplied by 5 multiplied by 11. Okay, so this gives us 10 pi by 11. So next is h cap 2. Similarly, so this 5 multiplied by this 2 component, so this 1 it will become 2, so it will become 4 multiplied by 5, 20 pi by 11. Similarly, we will get e to the power minus j 90 pi by 11, and h cap 10 it comes out to be e to the power minus j 100 pi by 11. Okay, now once we have got this h cap k values, then we have to calculate and or we have to find out the values of hn, and we know that the length of the length of the filter should be l equals to 11, okay, which is odd. So from here we get h of n is equal to 1 by n plus 1, or in other terms this is l, 1 by l multiplied by h cap 0 plus 2 of, here we will be having a real component, sorry I missed that, so here we will be having real components of k equals to 1 to l minus 1 divided by 2 h cap k e to the power j 2 pi k n divided by n plus 1, so this is nothing but again l. Okay, so again this is real, there should be real. So h of n 1 by 11 1 plus 2 of summation of k equals to 1 to 5, because l minus 1 by 2, which is basically alpha, so basically alpha, so here we get the alpha value of 5 h cap k e to the power j 2 pi k n divided by 11. So when you go for k equals to 1 to 5, if you look here at k equals to 1 to 5, we are having k equals to 1 to 5, here we have only two values, 1 and 2, and the rest of the values h cap k it will be zeros, right? So what we get, 2 of real of e to the power minus j 10 pi by 11. If you look over here, h cap 1 is e to the power minus j 10 pi by 11, so you get this value multiplied by e to the power 2 pi n by 11. Okay, similarly plus 2 of real of e to the power minus j 2 pi by 11 20 pi by 11 multiplied by e to the power j 4 pi n by 11. Okay, so the k value we are multiplying over here, there is a multiplier of k, so we are just multiplying that value, and when we are doing this we get this values as this thing, 1 by 11 1 plus 2 of real of e to the power j 2 pi by 11 n minus 5 plus 2 of real of e to the power j 4 pi by 11 multiplied by n minus 5. Okay, now what is the real component? It is basically in the form of e to the power j theta, so that is given by cos theta plus j sin theta, but we have to consider only the value of the real component, so we get 1 by 11 plus 2 by 11 real component is cos of 2 pi by 11 n minus 5, right, plus 2 by 11 cos of 4 pi by 11 n minus 5. Okay, so we get the HN value of this one. Okay, so we get the HN value of this one. Now, after we have got the equation for the HN, just like in our previous cases, we have to calculate the values of this H0, H1, H2 up to H10. Okay, so if you see, H0 is equal to 0.069, which is equal to H of 10, and H1 is equal to H9, H2 is equal to H8, H3 is equal to H7, H4 is equal to H6, and at H5 we get this value. Okay, so from here you can calculate the capital H of Z. Okay, so this is how we do the frequency sampling method, and it helps us in getting the values of the this helps us in designing the FIR filter. Okay, so today we will just restrict up to this one. So I would like you to practice this equation, this question, and then after you have done, you can design a high pass filter on your own. Okay, so first practice this one, this question, then we will discuss about the, you will be designing the high pass filter, and we will discuss there on how to design that. Okay, if you have any problem. So any questions? Anywhere you have not understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, how can you please explain normalization of frequency? Like, why we have taken 2 pi fc and pi by 2?
2 pi fc, pi by 2. Where? This one?
Sir, this normalization, yes, sir. Can you please explain
one
more time?
So, this is your cutoff frequency. It is in hertz, right? Now, when you are designing filter in the Z domain, what you have? You have positions in terms of 0 to pi. 2 pi, sorry. Right?
Yes, sir.
So you have to convert it to pi. If you are not converting into pi, you will not be able to design the filter. That's why if you are given the filter components in hertz, you have to convert that frequency component and normalize it to get the frequencies in pi by 2, in radians, not pi by 2, in radians component, in terms of pi.
So why we have taken pi by 2?
You see, we have not taken pi by 2. We have got omega c, which corresponds to 500 hertz. We have to find this, find up this equation and location. So the omega c, it is having the equation of 2 pi multiplied by fc by fs. So what is the cutoff frequency? 500 hertz is the cutoff frequency. And what is the sampling frequency? It is 2000 hertz. So you put the value 500 by 2000 and you get pi by 2.
Okay, sir. Got it.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Can you please explain step number 3, sir? I didn't get it.
Step number 3. Okay.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Sorry. It's okay. Your cutoff frequency is given by
pi by 2.
Then we have pi.
Pi
then we will have 2 pi. Now 2 pi minus pi by 2 is 3 pi by 2. This one is understood?
Okay.
Yes or no?
Sir, why we are taking two pass band means 0 to pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi.
Have you gone through the, I have discussed this in 2 to 3 the classes back. That means you have not gone through the lectures. If you are asking this, then you are not. You have not discussed. You have not gone through your lectures. Anyone else who can give an explanation why we are taking two cross bands? No one. It is very
surprising. So we take range of minus pi to plus pi. Instead of taking 0 to 2 pi, we take a range of minus pi to pi. That is why we are getting two pass bands.
That is there, but he is asking in this 0 to 2 pi, why we have taken two values.
Sir, here cutoff frequency is given, that is equal to omega c equal to pi by 2. But omega c in the plus, we put the value pi by 2. Cutoff frequency given. Again? Go to cutoff frequency to pi is 0, again pi to again 2 pi minus omega l, that means 2 pi minus pi by 2, that value will come equal to 3 pi by 2.
Yeah, correct.
Again 3 pi by 2 to last cutoff, last value that 2 pi, that value is given, that then between 3 pi by 2 2 pi.
Yeah, have you understood?
Yes sir, actually I forgot, so sorry sir.
It's not good, sir. You should study. okay, because I told you in that class, if you don't understand
sir,
this part, then it will be difficult for you to understand how to design filters in the digital domain. So suppose,
yes sir,
if you have a pole over here, it will be having some effect up to say omega c and minus omega c, right? So 0 to omega c, you are getting some point, and again 2 pi minus omega c, you will be having this band, right? Now, yeah, if you consider pi by 2, pi by 2 is 1.57, this is pi is 3.14, then it is 4.71. And 2 pi is 6.28 in terms of decimals, right? These are the coordinates which we want. So we want the point values in between 0 to 1.57 and in the range of 4.71 to 6.28, right? However, we have to keep in mind,
yes,
the points 0 and 6.28, they are same. If you look over here, they are same. So basically 4.71 to less than 6.28, because 0 we are already considering it, right? So,
yes,
if you see, I have now calculated k delta value at which points I have to sample. So, what is the first limit? 1.57, right? So, if you see 0, it is lower than 1.57, I will take it. Then k equals to 1, 0.57, it is less than 1.57, again I will take it. Then 1.14, it is again less than 1.57, so again I will take it. However, as soon as I go to k equals to 3, it is greater than 1.71. It is greater than 1.57, right? That means it is going out of this range of 0 to 1.57, right?
Yes.
So what are the values I will take? I will be taking the k delta values from 0 to 2, okay? Then similarly, the next one starts at 4.71. Where you are having 4.71 up to 8, if you see, it is lesser than 4.71. As soon as you go to 9, you get into this region. When k equals to 9, you get 5.14, and here we are having 4.71. So which is greater than 4.71? So we have got into the region, into the second region. Then we get the 10th point. The k equals to 11, as I said, I just calculated it to check whether this component is, whether I have taken the intervals okay or not. So the 11 point and 0, they are same, right? So 6.28. So I got 6.28. That means it's okay. So the delta values which I have taken, they are okay. So from the higher frequency components, we are getting the k values 9 and 10, and correspondingly the k delta values I have got. Okay. So in this way, I have got the points, say k equals to 0, k equals to 1, k equals to 2, which is in this range. And consequently, I have got k equals to 9 and 10. What about the other values? They are having the value of 0. K equals to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? So we have got 11 points. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have got 11 points, these black markings. So 3 to 8, they are falling in the range of where there is no amplitude response. So those values are zeros. So if you see, I have put this thing over here, H3 equal to H4 equals to H5 equals to H6. Equals to H7 equals to H8 equals to 0. So this is not H plus, it is equal to, okay? So that is a mistake. So please correct it. So all these values, they are zeros, okay? And you got these values which will be having the amplitudes. Now H cap 0, it will be 1. Why 1? Because K will be 0, right? Since K will be 0, the H cap value, this whole equation, e to the power minus j omega alpha K, it will become 0, okay? Now, how do you get it? So, e to the power minus j 2 pi by 11, this one, 2 pi by 11 multiplied by 5 into K, okay? So, in this fashion, you get this values.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Right. So, anything else?
Sir. Hello.
I can't hear you. Your voice is not audible.
Hello?
Your voice is too weak. Please come nearer to the microphone.
Hello, am I audible?
Yeah, bit better, but still you need to come closer to the microphone.
Sir, in step 2, determine the transfer function hk equal to 1, how we are getting that?
We have carried out a lot of things in our previous classes. We have already discussed when we started with the FIA filter design. Anyone who can tell why HK equals to 1 we have taken?
Sir, transfer function, impulse function is one, always taken in a path filter.
Yeah, for an ideal transfer function, we have considered that FIA filter, they have an amplitude of 1. Okay? Even if you look over here, H cap 2 and all this thing, if you find out the modulus of this one, you'll be having a value of 1. Right? Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Please go through the previous lectures. I can understand that you are not studying. Whatever you are asking, it has mostly they have been already discussed in the previous classes. Please go through that. Anyone else? No? So, okay, you please start doing this example.
Sir, for high pass, what we will take cutoff frequency?
Pardon?
Sir, for high pass,
5 hertz.
Sir, for high pass,
High pass. Same thing.
yes, sir,
Same, you
same.
take 500 hertz. You just
Okay,
have
sir.
to change the parameters here. You have to choose the correct parameters over here. And rest of the equations, they remain similar.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
The formula of del equal to 2 pi by n plus 1, is this fixed formula for calculating del, which is given as del equal to 2 pi by n plus 1, is it fixed for all type of filters?
You have to calculate. See, over here you are having the order of the filter it is given, okay? And
Yes,
from
sir.
here the length it comes out to 11. So you have
Yes.
to break this 2 pi into 11 points. N plus 1 means it is L. So you are breaking, sorry, 11. So you are breaking, when you are dividing 2 pi by the L, in this case it is 11, that means you are breaking 2 pi into 11 regions, or you are getting 11 points out of these regions, right? So
Yes.
suppose if it changes to, say, if I ask you calculate for 9 points, order of the filter is 8, and your L becomes then 9,
Right.
then this would become 2 pi by 9.
Okay.
Right?
So in this question, since we have low pass filter, that is why we have taken omega from 0 to pi by 2.
No. Even in high pass filter, you have to take 0 to pi by 2 pi. Oh no, sorry, you are talking about this 0 to pi by 2.
Yes,
Yeah, it is a low
yes,
pass
sorry,
filter,
sir.
so low frequency components they pass. Okay.
Oh, okay, sir. Yeah.
Now if you do the high pass,
Minus pi to pi.
this is pi. This is pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, and 2 pi. Okay. Now, when I tell you make a high pass filter, there will be two regions again. pi by 2 to pi. We have seen the high pass filter in digital domain, it looks something like this, pi by 2 to pi, and then it will again repeat. So pi to 3 pi by 2, right? It will be the mirror image across the pi. So then you will be having the region pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. Then if you look pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, it is up to 0.8. Here the values will be 1, and in other regions 0, 1, 2, 9, 10, the values will become 0. So there will be a change over here. Accordingly, you will be having this h cap values which will be different. H cap 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. You will be getting that. Okay. Then this thing, when you calculate this equation, then this k equals to 1 to l minus 1 by 2, l minus 1 by 2 is 5. So in this equation, you will be having the values 0 to 5. However, 0, 1, 2, they are zeros. These are zeros. You will be having values for this point, k equal to 3, 4, 5. So there will be another points over here. So you have to take three real points. There will be three cos terms. 2 by 11 cos of n cos of 4 na 4 multiplied 2 8 pi by 11 n minus 5, then you will be having cos of 16 pi by 11 n minus 15, and then cos of 32 pi by 11 n minus 5, something like that you will be having, and from there you calculate the hn values. What my point?
Yes, sir.
So anything else? No? Okay.